What's going on, my spicy people? My name is Dan the Man, and welcome back to another Thomas Friends reaction video here on my channel. Where today, guys, I'm gonna be reacting to more I Love Trains 323 videos. That's right, guys, I'm back, and sorry for not being able to upload for a couple days and all that, just dealing with some stuff, as you guys might already guess and tell what it is. I'm still stuck here, but I think I might be able to head back to my room in a little bit, and pretty much that. So to make up for, you know, I guess lost time or something, I want to do a reaction to another train simulator video by I Love Trains 323, or Nathan is what I've heard his name is. So if you guys haven't seen, I reacted to two videos, one called Little Western Rescue and one called Double Trouble at Work. I can't remember, but you guys might know what I'm talking about and something like that. Plus, the reason why I'm reacting to more of these videos is because I'm still planning on reacting to, you know, Defenders of Sodor, the Thomas and Friends train simulator fan movie. If I'm gonna react to that one, I gotta at least take a look at all these episodes. Those that have alternate endings of the episodes leading up to the movie, and I guess those that don't. You guys think I should react to the ones that lead up to the Defenders of Sodor, or should I react to all the episodes like this one all the way to whatever the recent one was before Defenders of Sodor? Let me know comments down below, and yeah, I'll see what happens, because I'm definitely gonna, you know, take a look at more of these videos before I actually do get into my reaction to Defenders of Sodor and all that. Maybe I can even do a review on it sometime. Or we'll see what happens. For right now, I'm gonna do a reaction to this video here, because today I'm gonna be reacting to episode 12 called Henry Sees Red. Now, if you guys do or do not know what this is, I think this video is based off of a story on the Railway series by Wilbert Audrey, because from what I do remember, the video I reacted to by iOS Studios, that train simulator video, Gordon Goes Foraging, if that's how you say it, that was apparently a railway series story by Wilbert Audrey. So yeah, there's like tons of Gordon Goes Foraging videos and Henry Sees Red videos, and since I reacted to one of Wilbert Audrey's railway series video stories into a train simulator video, then why not I react to another one, but, you know, by I Love Trains 323, where Henry gets painted red, huh? First it was James that was red, you know, has been red and always been. Then it was Rosie, went from being pink to red, because I like her in both ways. And now Henry. I don't know who's next on the list to be red, except for some red engines that haven't been seen around or noticed too much, but who knows, you know? So yeah, without further ado, let's get this started, because I'm excited to do my reaction to this one. But before I do, however, make sure you guys check out the original video down below the description, subscribe to I Love Trains 323, because he makes awesome animation videos along with his friends, and don't forget to follow me on my social medias, Twitter and Discord, links will be down below the description, and of course, let's do this in 3, 2, 1, and let's play! Army dudes, and I got the video up right here. Thomas the Train's Adventures, episode 12, Henry Sees Red. Now, like I said, I think this video is based off of a story of the railway series by Wilbert Audrey, because I know Gordon Goes Foraging was one of them, you know, when I reacted to the rewrite by iOS Studios. Now, I'm reacting to another one about Henry, but he becomes red, because there was James, Rosie, and now Henry. I don't know who's next in line to be red, although I could imagine there might be some engines that have red. Like, I don't know, it's just he has green stripes and all that. But I guess the point still stands, or... No, actually, no, it doesn't. But I do have the video here, and like I said, I am planning on reacting to Defenders of Sodor. It depends whether I do want to react to the episodes that have, like, the alternate endings of the characters that are going to be in it, or something different. Or I react to all the episodes until I get to there. What do you guys think? Let me know comments below on how you think I should do it, because I don't want to get to Defender Sodor yet. So I'm just going to react to, you know, videos and all that. Anyways, let's do this. Hope you guys enjoy. Again, check out the video down below the description by ILoveTrains323. Subscribe to his channel. And of course, let go. Yeah, we start off with 2 minute sheds. Hopefully you guys will be able to hear the video, because I'm sure it's... I put the volume up as loud as I could. Yep, and there goes Thomas in his Railway Series model. You see, ILoveTrains323 presents another episode of Thomas the Train's Adventures. And I didn't say wrong this time, that's just what it's called. But yeah, I know these are old videos because of how the engines look with their old Railway Series models, but it doesn't matter, because whether I react to videos that are old or new, I'll still enjoy watching them. Was I gonna say something else? Nah, probably nothing. Anyways, let's do this. Where we started off at a coal yard with Charlie, my dude. I kinda like Charlie.
The Northwestern Railway had to use a new sort of coal.
I think Charlie's a good character sometimes.
It made a lot of ash, and it collected in the engine smoke boxes, giving them pains.
Yeah, forget I said anything about him. So, bad coal, huh? Looks like the bad coal has returned, ladies and gentlemen. It has returned, indeed. With Henry.
One morning, Henry woke up feeling worse than usual.
Really?
What you need, Henry, is an overhaul.
Yes, sir. Does this mean I'll have to go to crew again, sir?
Not this time, Henry.
Overhaul?
These days, the people at crew couldn't do the work you need. No need to worry. We can do it at Krovin's gear. We just need to get you there.
If you say so, sir. There's James with the Express, and he's looking on like, what are you doing, James? I don't know.
That afternoon, Henry was coupled to James and the Express. The train was to stop at the works so that Henry could be uncoupled and move into the workshops.
Okay. Alright, let's do this. It's double train head time with Henry and James. Off we go. So yeah, I remember watching all the train simulator videos back in the old days of YouTube and all that with Thomas and all that. You know, first it was the Railway Series models, and now the Trains 2019 models, or even New Era. I am planning on learning how to make train simulator videos, but I might need some help from the experts with the tutorials and all that, and maybe get a better computer than this lovely piece of crap that I have here that I still use to this day. But anyways, Henry and James were running well with the express, with the passenger train, and we're making good time. But not for long, right? Probably. Looks like we're heading up to Gordon's Hill. Yeah, we are. Well,
Henry did his best to help James get the express over Gordon's Hill.
But? It worked? Okay, I guess it did work. Oh,
I'm glad we didn't stick there. We might be early to the workstation.
True.
But James spoke too soon.
She jinxed it?
As they approached the station, something broke off Henry and hit the station. A brick bounced off James's boiler.
Ah, that's got hurt. I even heard James said, "Mind my paintwork." Looks like I know that crack anywhere. It sounded like Henry broke something. Better stop here, everyone. And at the next stop.
They stopped the train, and Henry's driver looked over him for the problem.
What is it?
It wasn't long till they found it.
What was it?
Well, that's done it. Your wheel tire's broken and came off.
Oh. I'm sorry, Henry. Bad luck to you, my friend. Bad luck to you. So now what are they gonna do? Okay, put him over there, I guess.
James shunted Henry onto a siding and went back onto the train.
Okay. Looks like he's gonna take care of the work by himself, which shouldn't be that big of a deal.
An overhaul. May need retiring.
Says you.
And with that, James wished away.
Never mind him, Henry. You'll be fine. All you need is a good repair, and that's it. It was probably due to that bad coal. Anyways.
About an hour later, the works diesel arrived to shunt Henry onto the works.
Oh, works diesel? Wait, is that? Is that what I think it is? Oh, it's Bear! I recognize that engine shape from anywhere.
Don't worry, Henry. We'll have you fixed in no time.
With that, they pulled away.
I think that's Bear. Probably is. I'm right. So we got Boko, Ryan, Spencer, and Glenn.
Days went by, and Henry started to find life boring at the works. The men worked hard to make him better, but it felt like forever to Henry.
Okay. I'm not even sure if I want to pause throughout any of this.
At last, when he had passed the test to show he was mended properly, the men came to repaint him.
Okay, I guess I will right now. But guys, look, they have the red paint! And you know what that means!
But when Henry looked at their pot, he saw something completely different.
You've seen it now.
Red? Oh, no. There must be a mistake. Sir Topham Hatt wants me to be green with red stripes. Not red all over like tomato sauce.
Or James.
Don't worry, Henry. This is only an undercoat.
Par undercoat. What would the other engines say if they saw me like this? They would laugh like anything.
Really?
The men laughed.
Nonsense, Henry. You would look quite smart.
Would he? I don't think I want to see myself red. Oh, look, he's red! Look at that! Okay, well, that's
the next morning,
red paint right there.
His driver came.
Wake up, Henry. There's an emergency at the big station.
What do you mean?
The flight controller says you're to help.
But I can't go like this. They will all laugh like anything.
Yeah?
No choice. Bear's engine has failed and he can't pull the express.
Oh.
The flight controller needs you to take over.
Okay.
It's either us or a long walk for the passengers, and you know Sir Topham Hatt will not like that.
His fireman raised steam as fast as he could, and Henry, blushing with embarrassment, set off for the big station.
Good luck showing everyone your red paint, Henry. Like, I get that's your undercoat and all that, but you can't go out looking like that, I guess. First it was James being painted all pink, and now Henry being all red. Two engines having two undercoats that were supposed to go with their actual coats is some big mistake to worry about, I guess. At least there's no one around, so that's good. I mean, Henry doesn't look too bad with red, right? Like, how come his tender is still green, but the rest of him is red?
The Fat Controller was pleased to see him.
I think Henry should have been painted red all over, because that would make a little more sense, instead of, like, you know, his boiler and himself being red, and his tender being red. But it doesn't matter. Or Mr. Topham Hatt. Uncle Topham?
I feel so silly.
You do look unusual, Henry, but you have helped me out of a very awkward situation, so don't worry about it.
But Henry did worry, and soon, too soon for Henry, it was time to leave.
Great. It was time for Henry to leave. He had seen everything. I'm sorry,
the express was heavy, and Henry felt the drag of the coaches.
Oh. Come on, you can handle a heavy goods train and long passenger train like this. It shouldn't be that big of a deal for you. You know, being a big strong engine and all that. I feel like there's something on my head. Is there? I'm sure it's not that big of a deal. So yeah,
we're gonna need help on Gordon's Hill today.
Do we?
But they were in trouble before that.
Why?
As they approached Wellsworth, the brakes of the last coach slipped on, and they had to stop and couple it.
Crud. Well, that's one way to... That's something down to happen. Or go wrong.
To make matters worse, Donald, who should have been there to help, had been called away.
Wow. Now that's what I call a nasty accident. With whatever this is.
So Henry had to push the coach into the siding himself.
At least there's no one around to make fun of his, you know, to make fun of his red paint.
And without Donald, there was no one to help him up the hill.
So he had to do it all by himself. I'm sure he'd be able to handle that hill with one coach not to worry about. Oh. I thought that was George for a second, but it's Trevor.
Never mind. You can do it. You're an enterprising engine, remember?
More like Enterprising Engine 93, am I right? You guys think I should react to some of, Matt's videos? Let me know in the comments below if I should, because Enterprising Engine.
Henry snorted. He didn't feel very enterprising just then. The men at the works had mended Henry well, and his driver gave him as good a start as he could.
Alright, let's see if you can do this.
It was hard going, but now Henry felt fired with determination.
Can you do it?
Let them laugh at my red paint. I'll show them.
Let's see if you can do it. Yeah, no one's gonna laugh at you for looking interesting like that,
Slowly, Henry struggled up the hill.
Can you do it? He was struggling up the hill with the coaches behind him without a back engine.
I can do it! I can do it! Oh dear, will the top ever come?
I'm sure we'll.
And suddenly, there it was.
You see? You made it to the top!
I've done it! I've done it!
That's my number three! Well, there goes our number three, ladies and gentlemen. He's made it over the hill by himself. Good old Henry. I don't see why Mattel removed you in the first place. Like, you're still a really useful engine, for the show, the railway series, and more. And he's looking kind of nice with that red paint, not gonna lie. Even though it's his undercoat, I still think I prefer him in his green paint, to be honest. And off he goes to the main station, right? Probably.
After that, it was much easier, and they reached Barrow in Furness 5 minutes ahead of schedule.
Oh, all right, cool. Wait, who's that over there? Oh, there's Scotsman, or the Flying Scotsman is what I call him. I call him Scotsman for short because I feel like it's better to call his name for short like that than Flying Scotsman. Scotsman sounds better. And there's Peter.
The fat controller, who had been on the train, came to congratulate Henry.
Alright.
Well, John Henry, I'm very proud of you. Perhaps all my engines should be painted red.
Not all, but some.
Well, James's.
Yeah, and Rosie too.
But you certainly earned your proper green with red stripes.
Oh, thank you, sir.
You've earned it. At least Stanley's alright.
Which, of course, is just what Henry got.
And there's Diesel in the background right there. You guys see Diesel in the background? I just see Diesel. I noticed. Has anyone noticed Diesel behind Stanley over there? I know that he's part of the Defenders of Sodor story, so maybe this is a cameo or something? I don't know. And hey, there he is. He's got his nice coat of lush green paint. You looking good, my dude. You looking good. And now, Henry the Red Engine is no more. It's back to Henry the Green Engine, heading back to the sheds with everyone else waiting for him. Right? Yeah.
And when he returned, the engines cheered for Henry the Green Engine.
More like Henry the Red Engine, am I right? I'm just kidding. I thought he was going to do a whistle for himself at the end, but it doesn't matter. And it looks like Henry's back to being green, and that's it. Well, that was good. I like this, actually. That was a pretty good story. But before I do explain about it, let me just see the cast that are in this. See Henry as Mallard Fan 2062, if I said that right. James as 10 length 10th. Yeah, I know him. Sir Topham Hatt as Carson 08022000, or Carson. Wait, Jeff? Who's Jeff? Oh, okay. I think someone I didn't know of. All right, Epic Laffity Owl. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong, Epic, but all right. Let's see. Farquaad Engine. And that's pretty much it. Well, all right. I'm sorry if I said names wrong, but I do know about 10 Like 10th and all that, and the others. Do you guys think I should react to some of their other videos, like 10 Like 10th's videos, or Epic's videos? Let me know in the comments down below if I should, because I definitely want to take a look at more interesting videos that everyone's made, I Love Trains Productions. And that's where the story ends. You know what? This is nice, actually. I don't know how many of these Henry Sees Red videos there are, but I'm sure there's probably a few, because I know there's a few Gordon Goes Foraging videos. And hey, there's the movie I'm talking about, Defenders of Sodor, or as my own words, Defenders of Sonar. It sounds cool when I said it like that. But I'm going to react to this one pretty soon. I just feel like reacting to, like, all or some of the episodes that will lead up to this point here. Like this one, episode 13, Thomas and Oliver. You guys think I should react to this one next? Because I'm thinking of definitely that one. Let me know in the comments below if I should, because I'll definitely take a look at that one. And I don't know when I'm going to react to Defenders of Sodor. Maybe I'll react to it in the summer, whenever I get a chance to do it, that is. Because I'll definitely try to react to this video for the summer when I get through all the I Love Trains 323 videos. Or the train story videos, is what I meant to say. But yeah, now that I'm done with this, I'm going to have to end this here. And of course, get moving, because I got to deal with some other stuff soon. But hey, I hope you guys enjoyed, because I sure did. If you enjoyed this video, then leave a like. I'm going to say that for the end. What I meant to say is check out this video by ILoveTrains323. Links down below in the description. Subscribe to his channel. Support the voice actors that were in this. And thank you, of course, for watching. Yep, that's it, everyone. Like I said, that is my reaction to episode 12 of Thomas the Train's Adventures, Henry Sees Red. A video that was based off of, that is from, you know, the Railway series by the one and only Wilbert Audrey. Now, this is really good. I like this, you know, because anyone that remakes these stories into, you know, from books being told in stories into videos that people see is a brilliant idea, you know, because there was the Gordon Goes Foraging, and now Henry Sees Red. I don't know what else there is, except maybe there was one, I think there was one called Edward's Day Out. I don't know if that one counts or not, but I'll have to take a look at that and remember, because I did a reaction to that one by Annie C, or something like that. Anyways, besides that, I'm going to have to end this here, because I could tell that I got a lot of stuff to do before or after I upload and edit this and everything. But I'm still planning on reacting to Defenders of Sodor whenever I get a chance to, you know, like react to in the summer and all that. I don't know. But anyways, I'm gonna end this here. So thank you guys so much for watching my reaction to this video. If you enjoyed, then leave a like and subscribe, because it's always free, and you can unsubscribe if you want to. Don't forget to turn on the bell so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. And of course, leave a comment down below if you enjoyed this video, because I sure did. And let me know in the comments down below adventure videos, because, or actually, let me rephrase that. Let me know in the comments down below if I should react to some of the trains adventure videos that are connected to Defenders of Sodor, or just all of them, and then get to, you know, the movie. Because I'll do whatever there is. Just thought I'd put my opinion out there. Anyways, thanks again, I'm Dan the Man, and as always, I will see you guys next time in the next video. Bye-bye! Bye.